Here we are. This is the Ultimate Cup final. Two teams that have reached the final, relatively unknown. We've got Costa Fortune and the boys who are already here, Almost the Moon. Now, Almost the Moon, they've had a completely opposite from their league form to their cup form. In the league, they've not won a game. They've only managed to get 1 point from 14 games. But in the cup, they've reached the final and some great performances, not to mention the semi-final where they beat TSCI, who are the reigning champions. They beat TSCI 8-2 on aggregate, which was, if the scoreline was the opposite, where TSCI were winning 8-2, you wouldn't be surprised, but it was an absolutely amazing performance from Almost the Moon. We're going to try and get a few words with some of the guys shortly, but they're already here, bright and early. They've been here since 7:30, so they're really up for this, and I'm sure they've got a good game plan as well. So we'll try to get a few words now with some of the guys. Mo,
yeah.
I was just saying then in the introduction that you've had like opposites from your league form to your cup form. What's the secret with your cup form?
The secret is this league in general. You can't have one player who's out of their position. You can't have one player who's not playing their role. So that's what's been happening on Friday. We've got a good defence, even though the goals conceded might not look that way. Good defence, good midfield, but we've been lacking that creative front up top. And we've got the likes of Bobby today, who's been available Mondays. A couple of other players, Ishii, who does a good job on the left wing back. And that's the main difference. If you look at our performance Friday against Chido, dominated the game, but it's not top, that's been the issue.
So, Mo, I mean, you've been relegated.
Yeah.
It seems like you've got a good group of lads. They're all here, smiley faces, you're here early. You think you can keep that momentum going to next season and then come back straight away?
Yeah, the lads we've got, when they do turn up, they're amazing to work with, amazing to play with. But I'm confident if we can get these group of players here playing Division 2 next year or next season, then we'll be right back up, no issues.
What do you know about Costa Fortune? Do you know who their danger men are and how they play?
We've done a bit of pre-match analysis. They're a team who like to pass the ball and run. They've got always people running off the ball. So the battleground today really is in centre mid and our wing backs tracking the players. And we've got some strong centre mids in myself and Johnny. So Johnny's a bit of our white horse. So I think we'll be all right.
You've been in the team of the week a few times this season with some of your performances. And even though you guys have not won in the league, do you feel like you've got a lot of momentum going into this game?
Yeah, especially we got our first point on the seal on the board on Friday. So I think the momentum's with us right now. Especially we've got a whole team playing. And we got, we won 7-0 as well against TSCI, who are the defending champions. Treble back-to-back winners. So I think right now the mood in the camp is very positive. And I think right now it's not hard to say that, but we're the favourites in this game and hope it's going to be a great game.
Here are the other team, Costa Fortune. They've made an easy job of getting to the final. They're probably the favourites. We're going to have a word with Amo now, one of the star strikers. What's the secret of you guys getting to the final so easily?
Consistency, that's what it is. Yeah, that's the secret, consistency is key.
So the chances of today, I mean, you're going in as favourites. Are you feeling the pressure or are you just playing the game?
Just going to play the game, see how it goes.
So, Yusuf, you're here again tonight, making your Monday night debut as commentator. Can you tell the people at home why you're actually not playing today?
Thanks for inviting me this time, Arif, again. Appreciate it. Unfortunately, although we've won this cup, I think the most times out of any team, we did actually get hammered in the second leg of the semi. By Almost the Moon, who prepared well. They prepared well today. They've come, I think, nearly 40 minutes early, running drills, passing drills. They're taking this game seriously. On the other side, we've got Costa Fortune, excellent team. Every player they've got is technically very good. It looks like they've got Amar in net today. He's won this trophy with my team last season. And also we've got Abu. It looks like he's not starting. I think he's just going to be managing today. So yeah, it should be a good game. In the group, these teams played each other in the group stage. I think it finished 4 or 5-2 to Costa Fortune. So I think we have to put them as the favourites. This game started a bit of a subdued pace, really. It doesn't really feel like a final yet. I think we need something to spark it, really. So Dre with good body strength there. Might be a bit short, but you know, good control by Khalid. So Al Mustamoon do well. They really, you know, attack the ball in ones and twos. But this is where Costa Fortune show their quality. And that's a great pass out to the wing. Yusuf, left-footed. Oh, it's a good touch by Takir. But that was a great, great move. And I think we saw there what Costa Fortune are all about, really. Bobby is here. He's one of their star players. Left-footed, very skillful, quick. Oh, this looks a bit dangerous. It's a good layoff again by Bobby. And Ishii with a kick. Oh, just wide. Great effort by Ishii there. He's another quality player. They've got some excellent players in the tango position. Bobby with a good flick to Ishii. Just keeps it in play. Great flick back to him. Oh, it's just... Oh, it's a chance could be. Just about cleared. Just about cleared. Oh, it's a great move there. Just intercepted by Khalid. And Ibra pressured by Yusuf. Oh, took a risk and ammo. It's 2-on-1. Oh no, it's an awful pass out to his strike partner Yusuf, or to Johnny, and his strong player though. No, he's lost it. And Khalid with a snapshot. Good block there. And Khalid's got another free effort. Oh, he's Mo's flute. Oh, what a save by Takir. Mo tried the back heel, 1 yard from goal. Had to bury it though. Especially against a keeper like Takir on this form. Another great save for his team. Oh, death ball by Ishii. Bobby gets tackled there. He's struggling with the lack of time he's being given. Looks like a good move here now. Khalid to Ammo. Ammo keeps the ball. Lays it back to Dre. It's a great ball across, and what a save again by Takir.
He loves that.
He loves that save. That one was for the camera. We'll check that on the replay. Slow motion replay for him. We'll let him enjoy that moment. You can tell he's happy with himself. Two good saves so far. This ball's... Oh, it's a header. Couldn't quite see what happened there. Looked like a handball. Especially. And this guy, Abra, he plays like a keel. He's very solid. Yeah. Yeah, generally good on the ball. And Husnain now with a breakout. Has a long-range shot. Never going to beat Ammar from there. Ishii with this free kick now. You know, Johnny and Bra looking like staying back just to make sure. So whipped in ball. Oof. I think Ammar was in control, but that was a great, great whipped in free kick by Ishii. Almost the moon. It's 2-on-2. Mo just about. Oh, Bobby is through. Oh! It's half time. Weird first half, actually. Lack of intensity. Al Mustamoon worked very hard. I think Costa Fortune looking as though that they, you know, are owed this final at the moment, and they're not working as hard, although they've got the better quality on the ball and with the chances. Howard's ref has had a good half as well, not really made any major issues, but really there's not been much to talk about from either team, really. I think going into the second half, Al Mustamoon will be the happier. I think Abdul there, he's giving some of his knowledge. From what I know, it's not much, but yeah, better than nothing. But I think more of the same for them, and they'll try and nick a goal as this game goes on. Maybe the pressure for Costa Fortune of being the favourites for this game is you know, hampering them a bit. They are missing Ali Dutch, who has been probably their best player in the cup so far. Abu, you know, letting his team talk. Mo is really driving the proceedings there.
Yusuf, do you think that Al Mustamoon got better options on the bench?
To be honest with you, they've got like a second team, it looks like, today. And I don't really know what their other players are like, to be honest with you, away from the first team. The first team that they've got out is actually a good team. They've got, you know, especially with Ishii and Bobby, two real quality players. you know, and they have to add something to the team, not just energy. It has to be a change for a purpose, not just, you know, for the sake of holding a position down and kind of cancelling that out. But yeah, for energy-wise, if your game plan is just to run and you've got more runners on the bench with similar quality in terms of on the ball, then yeah, they can carry on doing the same job that's been going on. Al-Mustamoon looking like they're playing with a lot more energy. Oof, that's a horrible, horrible tackle. It was a good block, but the referee had already blown for the free kick, which was a correct decision there. It's the biggest wall we've seen in Ultimate. I think 15 players in that one. Khalid looking to bend it around. Great flick off the edge. Proves that their wall was effective there. Dominant, but straight to Mo. And Husnain, it's a great chance. Great save by Ammar. This is what Al-Mustamoon can do to you. And Johnny and Bobby linking up well, but Bobby's touch is loose. It's what makes Ammar such a great keeper. Not had much to do all game, and then when it matters, pulls out an excellent save.
The game ended 1-0. Cost a fortune. I won the cup. It was a tight game. Could have gone either way. Both teams had a similar amount of chances, but it was this guy who scored the winning goal. Yusuf. Yusuf. Scored the winning goal.
No videos, man.
Scored the winning. Ammar, you made a few important saves there. Was it always going to be as close as it was?
Not really. I made two saves through the whole game, so I don't think it was as hard as you think it was.
Thanks. So here are the winners. The winners of the Ultimate Cup Season 10. The first person to come and get his medal is Ammar. Key point, we kept a clean sheet, made some great saves, and he's slowly becoming an Ultimate League legend.
Thank you.
Mr. Mohammed. Played well. Excellent. Well played, mate. Assad, he's always picking up medals. Super sub. He came on at 0-0 and it ended 1-0. So he did his job. Played Assad. And then Dr. Dre here. Got a next album coming out next week. And he's the winning goal. The guy with the city top. And here they come. They look very proud and happy with that victory. 1-0, it was a tight game, but I think they deserved it with the amount of chances they had. Played Ammar. played. Jose Mourinho. Ultimate League, Season 10, Cup Champions. Cost a fortune!